Today we're going to look at how we can actually create a stamp in Bluebeam using an image off of our network. Let's get started. First thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to come up here and I'm just going to create a new document that I can use. To get my stamp created, I'm going to come up to the toolbar and click on Stamp dropdown. And I'm going to go to Create Stamp. When I do that, I now have the option to give it a subject. And in this case, it's going to be the name. And I'm just going to call this Shop Drawing Stamp. I can give it a size, so I'll just say 4x2, and I can change this in a few minutes. Everything else I'm going to leave the same. I want my text color to be red. If I have a line, I want that to be red, and I'm going to click OK. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go find my image. So I'm going to go up to the toolbar, and I'm going to click on Image. This is the one I want to bring in. I want to create this submittal stamp that I'll be able to use and distribute to my team. I'm going to click Open. Now to place it, all I'm going to do is I'm going to create a crossing window from left to right. So I'm going to click left, drag right, get a position where I want. I can use these blue shape handles if I want to crop it down at all. So maybe I don't need it to be as high. Get it positioned how I like. Now, there are two more things I want to do. When I place the stamp, I want it to recognize that I'm the user. And I also want to recognize what the date is without me having to manually put that information in. This is what's going to make an interactive stamp. To do that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to initiate the text command. I'm going to do that by pressing T on the keyboard for the keyboard shortcut. I'm going to draw a crossing window here for my text box. I now get this option of dynamic. When I choose dynamic, I have the ability to choose from a handful of fields that I can use to read from my review session. I'm going to choose user. Let me get this position the way I want, get it stretched out in case my user has a long name. And now the next thing I want to do is I want to choose the date. Same thing, I'm going to hit T on the keyboard, draw my text box, choose dynamic, but this time I'm going to choose date. So it's going to read the date for me. Now, we're going to put this in, and we may need to come back and adjust the formatting of this in case the date gets truncated and doesn't look proper or look correct. So I'm going to save. Now when I save, it is saving by default to the location on my machine for all my stamps. And I can change this folder if I need, but that's where it's going to go to start. I'll go back to my document here. I'm going to go up to the toolbar and click the drop down next to stamp, but this time I'm going to choose my shop drawing stamp. I'm just going to click to place it. Should have done a crossing window there. And there I go. So let's do that one more time. I'm going to choose my stamp, and I'm just going to click and drag to create my stamp. Now recognize it picked up my username. It also picked up the date. This is really helpful. We can go find images on our network that we want to convert into stamps. Simply bringing those images in and then using dynamic text, we can have Bluebeam recognize what the fields are, and it'll fill it out for us. I can now distribute this to my team, and everyone now has access to this stamp.